And I thought at one stage it was going to be like January the 6th in America. They wanted to storm the barricades, but it was I've never seen anything like it.
He's not talking about right-wing insurrections. He's talking about...
trash.
Melbourne's residents staging a mass protest while the inner city council of Yarra voted in a waste removal tax of up to $115 a year on top of rates.
We're being punished because of their financial incompetence. It simply isn't good enough.
Councillors accused of spending too much on their own wages.
It's a council that spent nearly 300% more on senior management than the executive over the last 14 years. But from the point of view of residents, all they're seeing is higher charges, higher fees, cuts to frontline services.
Locals more wound up than the time Yarra Council blew $22,000 on this banana.
I wouldn't call this public art so much as I call it the final boss in Donkey Kong.
I think everyone was really just disappointed that they weren't going to get a solid hearing from the council and not an opportunity to influence the decision.
I am devastated because that's just more money we have to outlay.
But dive a little deeper into that dumpster and Yarra's actually the last council in Victoria moving to charge residents for rubbish removal.
We can take bad news. We understand we have to manage our rubbish and recycling. Don't continue this process where you don't tell us. Vote in secret, in this case, pass on an extra charge that everyone's going to pay, and then expect that there'll be no feedback from the community.
Around the country, trash makes us tetchy. Both the Queensland and South Australian governments facing residents' rubbish wrath over waste levels in recent years. So with the bin fire that was last night's council meeting still raging...
I think it's just money-grabbing by the Yarra Council.
The government and the council are supposed to work for the people, not the other way around.
What is it about garbage that gets us so grumpy?
Well, the mayor of the city of Yarra, Claudia Nguyen, joins us now. Claudia, residents say this tax is a sneaky way to get around to the 3.5% rate cap brought in by the state government. How do you respond to that?
So we last night made a decision to separate the cost of waste from the rates notice, and we're doing that because we want to be really clear to the community what the cost of waste is, because the cost of waste is increasing really significantly.
So when you say you separated them, does that mean the rates are coming down by the amount that you've added to the cost of waste?
The rates itself will be coming down because the cost of waste will be pulled out.
Right. So are people paying more for this thing because costs are going up, or are they not and you're just itemising their bill for them?
It really depends on the property value. So what we're doing is, you know, removing that cost from the rates notice. How that's calculated is based on property value.
OK. So you've faced criticisms today, particularly in your council, because of the way you spend money. So when you add a charge like this, you can understand people get upset. The specific criticism is that you spend 81% of what you collect through rates on wages as opposed to 60%, which is what most other councils spend, and that your council is therefore bloated and inefficient. What do you make of that criticism?
We're really proud of the services that we run at the City of Yarra. We have libraries, leisure, gym, kindergarten, maternal health. We run a suite of services for our community and we're really proud to do so.
But doesn't every council run those services?
No, we run a lot more than the majority of councils. Again, like I've listed for you all the ones that we run, and a lot of councils don't run them.
The people of Yarra, though, they just want their bins picked up for free, well, as part of their rates that they pay. So can you understand the people's frustration that you're charging them for a basic council service while money is being spent elsewhere on gyms and that type of thing?
So the cost of waste is a challenge shared by all councils. So we're the last council to bring this in, and we know that it's something challenging that we do need to work with the community on. But that cost needs to be recovered, which is why we're being really clear to the community what that cost is.
All right. Are you worried you've just tossed your political career into the bin come next year's elections?
Look, I'm here to make the best decision for the community now and into the future. That's why I was elected, and I'm confident with how the community will see through that, and I'm really proud of the decision last night.
All right, Claudia, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bin chat doesn't get any better than this.
People get so angry about their bins, right?
Bins have got to get it. My bin didn't get empty 2 weeks ago. I've told everyone every day since it happened. Like, it's an outrage. It's so inconvenient.
Did you actually put it out, or is this just an excuse?
If my girlfriend's watching, I definitely put it out. Yeah. My close friends in this studio, I might have slept in.
Yeah, excellent.